In the future of space science, we see space no longer being the sole domain of very large organizations. It's going to be in the hands of the people.
A number of students here at the University of Alberta who were passionate about space came together. The objective was to design a small satellite called a cube satellite.
Who would have thought that you could access space as an undergraduate student? As soon as I heard of that, like, how can you say no to that opportunity?
So much anticipation and so much buildup. The actual moment of the rocket launching and going off into space was just like everything stopped.
To know on board in that cargo is a space vehicle that you've built, sitting on the pad and then watching it blast off into space.
This is a long 4 or 5 year journey that we'd all, you know, poured our blood, sweat and tears into. For it to be in space was nothing short of amazing. It was a surreal moment. Exalta 1 comes over the horizon, we point our ground station antenna at it, and then we establish a link of communication. Every time my hands are on the keyboard to fly that thing, I'm incredibly careful because I know it's everybody's baby.
The students have learned much, much more by having to reach a solution to their problems than they would just somebody trying to explain to them how do you design a particular system.
When I'm in the middle of a test, I can say, this question is hard. But you know, I fly a satellite, so you know, I can figure this question out.
We can dream big and succeed in those dreams because we've done it with a satellite.
Following Exalta 1 is Exalta 2. One of our mission objectives is to establish an open source CubeSat platform because we have all different kinds of people coming up with ideas of ways that we can use space to our benefit. We can really harness space to benefit the globe.